standing by at the Meadowlands.
Number 35, Duke's All-American Danny Ferry. An accurate shooter outside, and he makes the tough plays inside. Ferry leads Duke with a 22-point average, is one of the top candidates for College Player of the Year. As is number 32 for the Arizona Wildcats, Sean Elliott, Arizona's quicksilver forward, is also averaging 22 a game and has broken Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's all-time Pac-10 scoring record. In a battle of the game's top stars, Ferry and Duke meet Elliott and Arizona. The best of college basketball on NBC Sports. Today, Lute Olson and the second-ranked Wildcats of Arizona, the best of the West at 21-3, meet Mike Krzyzewski and the eighth-ranked Duke Blue Devils from the ACC. They're 21-4. From the Byrne Arena, the best of college basketball brought to you by the Heartbeat of America, today's Chevrolet. By new Michelob Dry, one taste and you'll drink it dry. By the Beef Industry Council and Beef Ford, beef, real food for real people. And by State Farm Insurance, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. 18,000 plus in the Meadowlands, Byrne Arena, to see this intersectional duel between two of the top teams in the nation, the Arizona Wildcats and the Duke Blue Devils. A game with a lot of marquee, as they would say down in Broadway. Hello, everyone. Dick Enberg with Al McGuire. This is one we've been looking forward to for months. A true preview of the upcoming tournament, Al, and it is a big game.
Yeah, you can tell it's a big game, Dick. New York market is so tough to sell. They get over 18,000 people here. You got to remember that Durham, North Carolina, is hundreds of miles away, and Tucson, Arizona, is thousands of miles away. They got two coaches in the hunt to be our Olympic coach in Barcelona, Spain, in 92, and two high first-round lottery picks.
All right, let's talk about Sean Elliott and Danny Ferry. We're going to see two men who legitimately could win the College Basketball Player of the Year.
Well, Elliott's more of a slasher. You don't want to put him on the foul line because he automatically bottoms it out, where Ferry can best passing big man in the game, can score down in the blocks, and has range.
All right, let's take Krzyzewski and Lute Olson, the two coaches, put them aside. Take the two stars, put them over here if we may take that luxury. Now, what is the key to the game?
The key to the game, gang, is who's guarding them. They're going to start out with Smith on Elliott. He can't foul Elliott because Elliott will bottom it out. He has to be physical with them, and he also has to pray a little bit.
Judd Bushler will play Danny Ferry.
Danny Ferry must play in front of him down low, must play out on him on the perimeter, make him drive. One of his problems is putting the ball on the floor towards the basket.
Will they last?
No, if they play 30 minutes either one, they'll be sitting on the bench because those two All-Americans will blow them there.
And we'll have the starting lineups from East Rutherford, New Jersey, in a moment. Out there, Sean Elliott, their star. Bushler, he'll have to guard Ferry. Anthony Cook, a shot blocker. Ken Lofton, plenty of speed in steals. And Matt Muehlbach is the point guard. Duke, 21-4. We'll send John Smith against the star Elliott. Danny Ferry, All-America. Abdul Nabi, Quinn Snyder, and Phil Henderson. And it's the Wildcats in the dark blue who start with the ball first. This is Bushler. Ferry comes out on him. Anthony Cook draws Abdul Nabi. Lofton leaves his man, Snyder, and then flips it to Bushler. Inside, and Anthony Cook can't hit the bank. Danny Ferry with a rebound. Ferry leads in scoring and rebounding, as does Elliott for Arizona. Abdul Nabi over Cook. Sean Elliott for Arizona. Down court to Cook. He beats everyone down court and scores, and he is fouled. Anthony Cook.
Yes, it's good by Anthony Cook.
Phil Henderson committed the foul.
And he
Watch this pass by Sean Elliott. He leads the ball towards the basket, not to the man. Now, as Cook goes up, he has inside position. He should finalize a three-point play if he can bottom the charity shot out.
Well, you talk about Danny Ferry's adroit skills in passing the ball. Sean Elliott is also talented in that regard. Arizona leads 3-0. It's 10 years since Larry Bird in Indiana State played Magic Johnson in Michigan State 10 years ago in the tournament. And there were the two big men who could pass the ball. We have that same kind of matchup today.
Arizona went to a zone, 2-1-2 zone.
Abdelnaby can't handle the lob pass, and then he fouls.
It'll be Arizona's ball, non-shooting foul, as Abdelnaby has his first.
Ala's foul prone. One of his problems is he doesn't have the proper foot movement to play defense. Defense, you play with your feet, not with your arms. You don't reach.
A quick move by Mike Krzyzewski. He brings in Christian Leitner, a 6'10 freshman from Angola, New York. He's in for Abdelnaby. Elliott over Smith. Rebound, Buechler. Put back for Buechler, and it's 5-0 Arizona. Wayne Snyder running the show. He's from the Seattle area, and of course, that's the site of the Final Four this year. Leitner and Elliott, and a push and shove, and Elliott is called his first. Elliott, who is now the all-time scorer in Pac-10 history, in 4 years breaking the record of Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, then Lou Alcindor at UCLA, set in 3 seasons with the Bruins.
I think the zone caught Duke a little bit off stride, and they took Aller out just to get him straight and say, hey, you're playing against the zone most of the time, and you analyze the defense.
Ferry to Abdelnaby, now to Ferry.
Off the glass.
Abdelnaby over Cook. Misses everything, and it's Sean Elliott the other way. Arizona, the Cats on the run, and Lofton's pass goes through the hands of Muehlbach out of bounds. Lute Olson, now in his 6th year in Tucson at the University of Arizona, and has he brought a program to the Cactus Country?
The miracle of the desert. Abdelnaby has to pass every now and then from that low position. They call him the black hole. That means the ball goes in, it never comes out. There's no bottom.
Henderson to Snyder.
Oh, hey, too much hands in there.
Ferry knocks Buechler down and then throws it away. And Buechler looks at the official saying, hey. Meanwhile, Krzyzewski didn't like what he saw. The crowd is certainly split in a neutral site, but it would be a Duke University audience. 20% of the student body at Duke in Durham, North Carolina, is from the state of New York. And they have a large alumni group here in metropolitan New York. But there's a good representation for Arizona as well. You'll hear their cheers. Anthony Cook working on Leitner. Double zero Cook, not there, and Snyder grabs the rebound for Duke. 5-0, Duke trails. They've not been able to score in the first 2.5 minutes. Snyder free, and then throws it away. Buechler recovers, sets up Muehlbach at the other end. 7-0, Arizona.
Duke has to settle down.
Mike Krzyzewski's team started with a 13-game winning streak, then lost 4 of 5, and now they've won their last 7, and they've won 7 impressively, averaging 25 points a win.
Alternating defenses every time down. They're in the zone now.
Phil Henderson off the mark. Rebound Buechler. Lofton, he can fly. Sets up Elliott. He wanted it. He's going to take it. Sean Elliott off the rim. Rebound Snyder.
Quinn, you got to first analyze that defense.
Ferry takes his first shot. Both teams cold, but Arizona leads 7-0. Duke has not scored in nearly 4 minutes of play.
Lofton's the quickest guy on the floor, either team.
9-0. The Cats claw to an early lead over Duke with 16-13 remaining in the opening half.
Situation like this, Duke should work the clock for about 15, 20 seconds, get their composure. That's a 1-1-3 there now. They'll double down low.
John Smith, he's their best three-point shooter, and he connects on the home run, 9-3. It took 4 minutes and 10 seconds for the Blue Devils to score. Snyder on Lofton. Gets a pick from Elliott. Anthony Cook moved that foot before he got the ball on the floor, and with it we have a timeout. 4.5 minutes have been played here at the Meadowlands. Arizona leads by 6. Nearby and played for Bob Knight with the Cadets and is a captain, retired U.S. Army. Did not take the timeout, waited for the television timeout in the early going despite the fact down 9-0. Now it's 9-3. Snyder for 3. Not quite. Out it comes to Lofton. So Bushler, what a pass by Lofton. Inside to Cook.
Tricky got away with a foul that time.
Lofton for 3. And Lofton has 5 points, and Arizona leads 12-3. Robert Bricky in now for Duke, number 21. Henderson. Ball won't drop for Duke. Leitner can't save it. Muehlbach with a steal, and it's all the way from Muehlbach. He sets up Bushler. A wise play by Muehlbach. Good feed. Bushler with 4, and Arizona builds its biggest lead, 11 points.
At the present time, Duke is uncertain, indecision. Even if you do something, do it if it's wrong. Don't do nothing.
Yeah, they've made 1 field goal in 5.5 minutes. No basket, traveling on Leitner. Duke is now 1-for-7 from the floor.
It's 3 going in. This is unselfish. That's what Luke seems to note it for, being unselfish. Kicks it back, automatic.
He knew that Henderson was building steam to go up for the block, so he just took the defender with him and set up Bushler.
Lofton's a little bit too quick for Snyder.
Sean Elliott looking for his first points and doesn't get them. Bricky rebounds for Duke. So Elliott's the only Wildcat starter who has not scored. Muehlbach forces the turnover. Ferry trying to spin away, and he touched it last. 14-3, Arizona leads. Sixth turnover for Duke. Arizona's committed just 2.
Got to toughen up the defense of Blue Devils.
Smith on Sean Elliott. Ricky out on Bushler. Quick pass by Lofton to Cook. What a setup by Ken Lofton, and it's 16-3 as Anthony Cook has 5. Hard to believe this Duke team that's been red hot has scored only 1 basket, 3 points in 6.5 minutes.
You got to get Bricky in the game.
There he is.
They're doubling down anytime the ball is on the baseline. They're doubling down.
Another turnover. Snyder starting before he had the ball on the floor.
He moved in Kubek because he wants outside shooting. So next time down, watch Kubek take an outside shot for Duke.
Oklahoma lost at Missouri yesterday. Arizona started the week in second place in the polls. Elliott shoots and scores his first hoop. It's 18-3, and what a start by the Wildcats.
That's Elliott's type shot. Penetrates not all the way, pulls up about 10 feet away.
7 minutes gone. 18-3, Arizona looking for perhaps to impress the pollsters and be the number one team, as we're just weeks away from the start of the NCAA tournament. Smith. He has all 5 of Duke's points. 18-5 Arizona. Quick down the court, and Cook is fouled by Kubek, who's just in. Greg Kubek, a sophomore from Clifton Park, New York, north of Albany, commits his first foul.
Here's an overhead look at this shot. Nice pass by Lofton in there. Just clears. Kubek reaches in. Get 2 shots.
You know, part of the experience for Arizona, Lute Olson put them on a bus yesterday in Manhattan, took them around, showed them the sights, and Anthony Cook, they stopped down in the lower end of Manhattan and Wall Street area. Cook got out, and typical of any tourist, he saw this nice man on the street selling watches. So he bought this nice new watch for only $20. By the time he got on the bus, it wasn't working.
Well, by the time he woke up this morning, his wrist was green.
So all of his teammates keep asking, what time is it, Anthony? What time is it?
Well, better than buying a couple hundred shares of a company that's not existent.
20-5, and Ferry with a feed to Bricky.
Block, nice block, excellent block that time.
Anthony Cook, who is the all-time Pac-10 shot blocker. Elliott working on Smith. Good pass to Bushler. Bushler around Ferry. Gets his own rebound. Gets his own rebound. Blocked by Ferry, and here comes Kubek.
Duke is reaching rather than jumping on the boards.
Smith has been their scorer, and now he has all seven of Duke's points. 20-7, Arizona, with 8 minutes play.
He started getting hot 7 games ago, Smith. When they got it on that streak, they started against Clemson.
Elliott using that good first step, and a block by Ferry, controlled by the All-America Ferry. Inside to Bricky. Oh, no whistle there. So Cook rebounds, and he's fouled by Bricky. Yeah, they're letting him play, and that'll be the subject of our halftime rules of the game. State Farm's the rules of the game, that sometimes the no call is the best call. In the spirit of the game, timeout. The 11 minutes and 26 seconds left in the opening half. And Arizona, impressively, by 13.
There are some
semifinals last year, 1 and 2, but the Sooners lost in Missouri yesterday. Georgetown has won. North Carolina's won. We'll have North Carolina and Duke next week. Syracuse in the fifth place. Well, we'll show you the rest when we have a moment.
John Thompson did not get burnout after the Olympics. He's done a great job this year. Next year, I thought that Georgetown would be number one. But this year, they're right there.
You see Duke coming into this game in eighth place. That was earlier in the week. They've already won a game against North Carolina State at home on Thursday. That was the final home game for the Blue Devils and the seniors. And Arizona beat Arizona State. Final home game for the Wildcat seniors in Tucson on Thursday. Otto Nabi back in the game. What a block by Cook!
That was close to goaltending.
Almost stolen by Sean Elliott, who dives out of bounds. We have a couple of new entries for Lute Olson's Wildcats. For the first time, Matt Othick, a freshman from Las Vegas, is in.
Watch this block. Catches the ball right at its apex.
Back to live action with 9 minutes played, 20-7.
Nice move.
Arizona hit the underside of the board, did Henderson. Abdul Nabi loses it. Elliott. What a control by Elliott.
Numbers are right.
Muehlbach is fouled by Snyder. First on Quinn Snyder.
I thought Muehlbach that time should have waited for the secondary break.
No foul. Charge to.
There goes Allah up there.
But watch Elliott's control here. Look at that, with men around his ankles, dribbling the ball, maintaining, and then getting the clearing pass to Muehlbach to set up the play. Here's a candidate for the academic All-America team. Starter Matt Muehlbach has a 3.3 average. Wants to major in political science. That name familiar to you fans in the Midwest, Kansas City, famous Hotel Muehlbach, and he's part of that family.
He scores in bunches. They go 1 for 4 from 3-point land, then turn around, hit 4 out of 5 from there.
22-7. Muehlbach has 4.
It's 1-1-3. They double down when the ball goes on baseline. Watch.
Game starting in a similar fashion to the one we saw yesterday, Georgia Tech and Notre Dame, when Notre Dame jumped out to a big 17-point lead in the first half. Couldn't hold it in the second half. You get the sense that Duke will find him. There's going to be traveling against Muehlbach, and Arizona's bench screaming that he was knocked down. He didn't fall down.
I got to agree with Luke on that one. There was contact. These are big East officials, or neutral officials. Arizona's from the Pac-10, and obviously Duke is from the ACC.
To compound the call, a technical has been called against Arizona. And he's saying there's two mistakes. That's what Olson's saying. You made the first mistake not calling a foul, and now you've compounded it. Danny Ferry will take the points, and certainly the Blue Devils need them. The first point of the game for Ferry.
The thing I believe with technical fouls, the rule into the future should be when your team gets a technical foul, that you're charged with a timeout.
Boy, that would have hurt you when you were at Marquette.
We'd have no timeouts at the end of the game. Don't forget, you only get 4 timeouts in a television game.
Ferry, after the 2 free throws, can't hit the jumper, and it's out of bounds to Arizona. And a foul is called on Duke.
You know what's happening, Dick? Cook got them all thinking. Cook got them all thinking with that pink elephant. Every time they go for a shot, they're looking for Cook to come over and block. He's one of the best rejectors in college game today.
Phil Henderson got the foul, his second. Six on Duke, team fouls, only one against Arizona. Abdelnaby all over Cook. Cook around him. And he scores it. Anthony Cook, a senior from Los Angeles, California, went to Van Nuys High School in the San Fernando Valley. Ferry, that's his shot, but he can't drop it, and little Othick is up to get the rebound. Elliott pumps. The two stars are cold. Cook gets the rebound. Othick again. Matt Othick. It's a three-point play, and it's 27-9. Ferry.
Finally, get out of the gate. Give a head and shoulders fake.
27-11, Arizona. 9 minutes to go in this opening half. Unusual. Two left-handed guards on the floor for Arizona. Muehlbach and Othick, a sophomore and a freshman. And there's the turnover. Muehlbach. A reminder, at the conclusion of today's game, we'll be selecting a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player from each team, and Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to the General Scholarship Fund of each university.
And for Duke, John Smith replaces Quinn Snyder.
John Smith is back in for Quinn Snyder for Duke. Chris Ferry, Bushler, hawking him. Bricky works against Muehlbach. Good move by Robert Bricky, but he can't hit. Cook, who's got a peck basket full of rebounds in this first half, has another. Elliott, quick move around Bricky and sets up Cook. Rebound Ferry. 27-11, Arizona. Anderson can't hit. Boy, they are ice cold, the Blue Devils. Sean Elliott, he can
Blue
handle
Devils
the ball.
Are shooting.
Good pass to Muehlbach for three. Matt Muehlbach makes it 30-11, Arizona. 8 minutes to go in the half. Ferry, they needed that one. A two-point play. Six for Danny Ferry.
Danny Ferry from Robert Bricky.
Elliott got away with a walk that time.
Rebound Phil Henderson to Ferry.
Danny's on a tear now.
Over Bushler, blocked by Cook. Anthony Cook, what timing.
Coach K wants goaltending.
And they're going to call traveling at the other end. No basket for Matt Muehlbach.
He was traveling.
Watch this move here. Cook comes from the backside. He's been a one-man wrecking crew. No, that ball was still on its way up.
Cook with a couple of blocks in this first half. We have a timeout, 7 minutes and 21 seconds on Cook's watch. Remain in the first half. We didn't expect this kind of start for either team.
I tell you, gang, what's happening out there is Cook is driving everybody crazy. He's got them all thinking. They're looking where he's coming from. He's playing a one-man zone. He's stopping the whole Duke team by blocking the shots.
And Duke with only 13 points in nearly 13 minutes. Inside the pass to Ferry, knocked away and controlled by Sean Rooks just into the game, a freshman for Arizona. Here's the kid with the choir boy looks, but he plays a devilish game, this Othick. And they're going to call 5 seconds on him. That was a quick five.
Bushler's playing quite physical on Danny Ferry. Watch this time down.
Anthony Cook taking a breather. Four blocks and 9 points in this first half. Smith closely guarded by Rooks. Anderson got away with a walk and misses the dunk. Out of bounds to Arizona. Well, Henderson is 0 for 6, part of the cold shooting for Duke. They've made only 5 of 23 attempts.
He drives the baseline. When he gets up in the air, he decides to dunk it, but didn't have control of the ball. He needed more stickum on his hands.
Sean Elliott into the lane, sets up Brooks, and a foul on Bricky. It is exciting to see the big man not only handle the ball, Ferry and Elliott, but to be able to set up their teammates. I mean, they're going to make everyone good on whatever team gets them in the NBA. At the line, Sean Brooks, the 6'11 freshman, Richard freshman from Fontana, California. Playing more and more, averaging about 6 points a game.
Really soft shooting of the Blue Devils.
And reflected in the score, 31-13, Arizona. Ricky for two, his first of the game.
Good change of defense. I feel that Duke should come out and play man-to-man all over the court, try to break the rhythm and tempo of the Wildcats.
Sean Elliott showing you how he can handle the ball, but misses the short shot, and it's out of bounds to Arizona. Ken Lofton will check in for the Wildcats, starting guards, and top prospect of the Houston Astros baseball organization. He's a center fielder, left-handed hitter. They say he's the fastest man in their organization. Played Class A ball last year. Ricky makes the interception, but was on the sidelines.
Once the ball player looks down, that usually means he's out of bounds, and the ref normally just blows. He says, you look down, you're out of bounds.
Elliott triggers the inbounds pass to Lofton.
Too close, Henderson to blow by it.
Ooh, right through the hands of Elliott, who is open, breaking underneath. 31-15, Arizona.
Early in the game, to say a key time to score, but a key time right now on this possession.
Bill Henderson to Bricky, and the foul will be on Elliott, his second. The only game in which Elliott has fouled out was the game they lost against North Carolina. They've lost to North Carolina on the road. They've lost to Oklahoma by two at Norman, and they lost at Stanford. The only conference loss. Here's steal by Mason, and it's Trubeck firing short. Ricky converts the rebound. 31-17. Back-to-back goals by Robert Bricky.
Bricky's their best athlete. He can destroy you down low.
Blocking foul on Bricky, and the fans for Duke wanted Elliott to get his third foul. Instead, it's the third on Bricky.
Very difficult to foul out a Super All-American. Looked to me that time that Bricky was in good position. Better off a no call. Here's an angle from the top.
He's moving, he's sliding into him. I'd have to agree with the official's call, so that's how tough a call it is. You saw it one way, I saw it another.
Angle call.
Sean Elliott at the line, and boy, get out the superlative for this 6'8 senior from Tucson. He's the only player from the state of Arizona on this Wildcat team, and what a player from Cholla High School. He was on the 86 World Championship team, coached by Lute Olson, that beat the USSR in Madrid. Didn't make our Olympic team.
Going back to that last call, Dick, if you'll notice as you watch basketball in your life that any ties or pushes go to the superstars.
Ferry again can't hit, and Pushler has the rebound. 2-on-2 break.
Over to Elliott. Off the glass. Nice pass again.
Pushler misses the layup, however, and it's Ferry the other way for Duke. Kubek with a drive and threw up a prayer. Bushler, he's claiming some boards. Lofton to Elliott for three. They're going to call that two. Only two. Sean Elliott now has six. And it's 35-17 Arizona.
Close the gap before halftime.
Kubek inside, or is that Leitner? Leitner inside to make the basket. The good-looking freshman in 6'10".
Entry pass is made by Ferry.
4.5 minutes to go. Arizona by 16. They led by as much as 19.
Don't play him close, Snyder. Why, that dribble's alive. He'll go by you. So long, Snyder. After he kills the dribble, play him.
Nice.
Austin inside to Cook, who has returned. Anthony Cook is short. Elliott gets the rebound. Oh, good body control. Sean Elliott with 8 points for Arizona. 4 minutes to go in the first half.
You know, you said about him not making the Olympic team. He said he never knew what he was supposed to do.
The strength, not defense, and John Thompson really emphasized that. Field goal by Danny Ferry, who has 8 points, 37-21.
I thought the exhibition tour, he had a bad tour. He never seemed to get the sink.
Elliott around Kubek. Rebound Ferry. He'll slow it up. No, now gives to Henderson. And Henderson scores. Elliott with two fouls had to let him go. First points for Phil Henderson. And a little run here for Duke to cut the lead down to 14.
I don't think that Coach Luke will accept that. Elliott not playing that man on defense that time.
Lofton hanging and missing badly. Leitner with a rebound. And now the Duke fans sense a rally. Ferry. And a foul on Buechler. No basket.
That's only the third personal foul on Arizona. Team foul.
And so Buechler with his first foul, and Duke will play it from the side. And a timeout, television timeout, with 2:57 remaining in the opening half. Lute Olson's Wildcats by 14. The country, and Duke, in fact, second best in the nation coming in this week with a 56% field goal percentage, but shooting only 32% the first half today. Anthony Cook deflects that pass out of bounds.
Got to feed post position from the side, not from the top.
Senior John Smith off to the freshman Leitner. Ferry working into the post. Henderson to Ferry, off his hands. Can Leitner save? No. Another turnover charged against Duke. Both All-Americans, Elliott and Ferry, with 8 points. Rebounds, just one to the side of Elliott, who has two fouls. First half, Arizona with a 14-point lead. Shot clock, still plenty of time, down to 16-15. And a steal by Ferry. A long pass to Leitner. Quinn Snyder with the assist, 4 points for Leitner. So that 19-point lead, down to a dozen. Can't hit the three-pointer. Here comes Henderson the other way for Duke. Snyder in the other wing. Good move by Henderson. Blocked by Cook. Goaltending Cook.
Give credit to that goaltend to Coach Mike. He kept saying to the officials he's been goaltending. I doubt whether that time was goaltending. You judge. Nice second move behind his back. No, that ball was still on its way up.
Yeah, that was a block. In fact, the ball was just rim high on its way up.
One of the toughest calls to make for an official. When is the ball at the top of its peak and starts on its way down?
That was a better block than the previous one. 37-27. Arizona's 19-point advantage has been whittled to 10. A minute and a half left. Sean Elliott weaving inside, and the foul on Duke. That'll go against Brian Davis, number 23, the freshman. Halftime, Jimmy Cephalo with other basketball scores and results. State Farm's rules of the game will feature the no call. And our Foot Locker Slam Fest, Carl Lewis and Matt Biondi. That's a golden matchup from Seoul. Biondi, the great swimmer, student out of Cal. And Carl Lewis, a former Houston All-American. Elliott, a good free throw shooter. Unable to connect.
I think he shoots about 81%. Normally, if they miss on their second shot, not their first.
38-27, the ninth point for Sean Elliott, who is 1 point away from scoring in double figures for the 100th straight game.
This is defense that gave Duke fits earlier, 1-1-3.
Ferry with a good lob pass, and Cook has another block, but a foul on the other side from Buechler.
Bushley got a piece of him from the inside.
Second on Bushler, that'll send Danny Ferry to the line.
You notice they're always double-teaming down low. Bushler on one side of them, Cook on the other.
His defense has been the best we've seen for any player this year. Anthony Cook.
He only blocked six shots, Dick, but he really, in the heads of the Duke players, he's blocked about 20 shots.
Sean Elliott, that knee injury was suffered 2 years ago in his sophomore season. Almost carries that as just a reminder. He doesn't need it anymore, but wears it.
It's a security blanket.
109 to go, and Duke has the game down to a 9-point contest. Othick with Snyder on him. Elliott. Smith's done a good job against Sean Elliott. Buehlbach and Snyder now.
Spreading it out, trying to work the clock a little bit.
25 seconds on the shot clock. Othick inside. Rooks unable to hit, and Abdelnaby for Duke. And the Blue Devils now a chance to carve even deeper into that big Arizona lead.
Arizona can now afford to gamble because they still got two team fouls to give before they get to the 1-1. They've only committed four team fouls.
Shot clock is off. Final seconds, first half. Arizona 38, Duke 29.
First thing that Coach K is going to say to these officials, how come they're attacking us and they only committed four personal fouls?
Ferry for three. Oh my, what a play by Ferry. Othick the other way. Rebound Ferry, and what a comeback by Duke. And Danny Ferry's three-pointer in the final seconds pulls the Blue Devils within six.
Here's his shot just inside the NBA line. He's on a tear. Watch for him in the second half.
Two of the nation's best, and it's heating up at the Meadowlands at the half. 38-32, Arizona. 22-7 lead, and then in the final 6-7 minutes, it was Duke outscoring Arizona 21-8 to make it a close game, just 6 points at the half.
Well, when you're down by 19 points, the break that Duke had was so early in the game. They're back in the ball game now. It looks to me like it's going to be a wire job, but decided in crunch time at the very end.
As we were flying up from Atlanta after the Georgia Tech Notre Dame game last night, I was quizzing the coach here about the players other than the stars to watch, and he says, you know, I'm anxious to see Anthony Cook of Arizona, and he was something to watch the first half.
Anthony Cook reminds you something of a Bill Russell. He can play a one-man zone and intimidates all the players on the opposing team. What happened at the end there, where they call that goaltend, is every time down that he blocked the shot, Coach K would jump on the official and say, goaltend and goaltend. But you keep saying that, Dick, eventually they're going to call goaltending. But he's going to play wing in the NBA, and he's definitely a potential second-team All-American.
And Cook has done that throughout his career. The six blocks today give him 261 block shots in his Arizona career. That's a Pac-10 record, and he doesn't foul. He's fouled out only twice in his whole career, and none the last 2 years. So his timing and his body control is terrific.
I think what's going to happen in the second half here, Arizona's speed and quickness has been one of their major artillery weapons. It's going to hurt Duke a lot. But I think in the second half, they will start to get in foul trouble, and Duke will start going to the charity line with 1-1s with about 8 minutes to go, and that could be the death knell for Arizona.
Whether it is a court that neither team knows well that's a difference, or whether it's just good defense, both teams shooting over 50 on the year are under 40% in the first half today. We'll look at the other statistics. We'll have the second half for you in just a moment. Under 40% from the floor. Nine free throws made, four for Arizona. That counts for their lead of six, turnovers at nine aside, and they've corrected Anthony Cook's block total, four official blocks for Cook of Arizona.
It seems like 14.
And with your coach's eye, indeed, just one good block shot is worth more than one, because it makes everyone think.
On a defensive end, it's like a three-point goal on the offensive end.
And Cook with 9 points to share the scoring lead with the All-America Sean Elliott. And Danny Ferry leads all scorers with 13. John Smith had the first 7 points of the game for Duke.
Look for Duke to be more patient this time and pumping the ball inside.
Elliott starts with Bushler, Muehlbach, Cook and Lofton, same five that started the game. Duke with the ball first in the second half. Features Henderson, Ferry, Leitner, the freshman, Snyder, and Smith. Inside to Leitner.
Nice bounce pass.
Ferry starts the second half where he ended the first by scoring again.
You're going to see more of that patience. And Arizona's going to try to giddy it up, led by Lofton.
Inside, knocked away by Leitner, but it comes out to Lofton. That's the closest Duke has been. Remember, the Blue Devils fell behind 9-0 at the start of the game. A pushing foul on Smith as he dumps Lofton away from the ball.
He did it out in the open. Lofton was picking him. Smith only wants to pay attention to Elliott.
First foul on Smith. I asked him before the game, did you take your morning defense pill, knowing he's going to guard Elliott? He said, I took two.
He said, make him work. That's the key.
Lofton, too quick on that move. And the traveling call gives Duke a chance to draw even closer. It's 38-34, just starting the second half. Snyder all the way.
Arizona has to up-tempo the defense and the offense. Get back into their game.
Snyder's first points of the game, and it's Arizona by only two. They led by as much as 19 in the first half at 30-11.
They're trying to isolate Elliott.
Ferry had his hands on the ball. Lofton knocked away and stolen by Snyder.
No call, no harm, no foul there. Nobody got an advantage.
This would give Duke the lead. Rebound Elliott. So Ferry trying to pump a three-pointer.
I think he's getting mixed up between the NBA line and the collegiate line. The red one is the collegiate line, the white one is the NBA.
About a four-plus-foot distance and the differential. Buschler with an interception from Ferry gets the rebound blocked by Smith. And it's Elliott. He can't score. Leitner rebounds. And it's Arizona starting cold the second half. Ferry. And he was fouled.
Luke knows they're out of sync. They're out of rhythm.
He sends in the freshman, Matt Othick. Third foul on Buschler, and that's a big call. Buschler assigned to Danny Ferry. Here's Ferry, a 76% free throw shooter. Looking for his 16th point. And he's 5 for 5 from the line today.
Next time down, you'll watch Arizona. We're going to 1-1-3 zone trap.
This would tie it. And it is tied at 38 with 2 minutes gone in the second half. They start anew and a timeout, Arizona.
Good call by Luke. Don't wait for the commercial timeout. Excellent call.
Wait a minute. They're calling it a technical foul on Lute Olson.
Oh, excuse me. I thought he said T.
T for technical, not timeout, and that would be the second on Olson, one away from being excused if that's the case. There's certainly some confusion. Is it a technical or is it a timeout?
Arizona.
Well, no clarification at this point. They had Danny Ferry at the line.
I would think it was a timeout, but I could be wrong.
I think we got both, technical and a timeout.
If my rule had come into play here now, Dick, that would mean two timeouts they'd lose. Each technical, you lose a timeout.
Boy, what would you do with commercials then? The locker room, second technical foul. And that'll send Danny Ferry to the line and a chance to give Duke its first lead of the game. Ferry's a perfect 6 for 6.
He's fundamentally sound, has great work ethics.
Olson sees Ferry give Duke the lead at 39-38. And Duke gets the ball.
Again, as I said at halftime, Duke will be more patient. Arizona has to up-tempo their defense, so they can't be that patient.
Inside to Leitner. And it's 41-38, and Duke is on a roll. They've now outscored Arizona 30-8 in the last 10 minutes.
It's Elliott's time.
There he is, Sean Elliott, way off the mark.
Good rebound, Bushler, and he puts it in. Judd Bushler from Poway, California, in San Diego area, has six. John Smith inside to Ferry. Ferry, a good pass to Leitner.
Excellent pass. He was doubled down by Cook, which left Leitner open on the weak side.
8 points for Leitner. He'll be inheriting a lot of the Danny Ferry role next year as a sophomore as Ferry graduates.
It's not the same traits, but not as perfected. He passes well, can score, can motor better than Danny up and down the court.
But he doesn't have those moves outside or the outside scoring touch.
Doesn't have the toughness yet. Danny gets from his father, Bob, general manager.
The Bullets was a 6'8 player at St. Louis University in his school. Elliott. Dropping the shots away, normally does. Ferry got the rebound. 43-40 Duke. Phil Henderson underneath the Leitner. No one guarding Leitner, and he can't
That's
score.
That's a walk. He got away with a walk.
No, he didn't. They called it. Delayed whistle. They called the walk.
Good call. Got to remember that Duke has never lost in the middle lanes. They're 7-0 here. Here's the fake. There's the walk, up and down. That's a no-no.
People have asked why seven times here at the Meadowlands. Well, a lot of that is just good recruiting visits. This is a good place to showcase your talent and talk to the high school players around the area. Third foul on Phil Henderson.
Well, both coaches do.
Phil Henderson.
Young player going to Duke out of this area early, a point guard that Mike Krzyzewski is very excited about. He'll take the spot that Quinn Snyder will leave as a freshman.
He leads the number one high school team in the country, St. Anthony's.
43-40, stolen by Snyder, away from Elliott. And then it goes through the hands of Robert Bricky. Wanted him to go high.
I thought Quinn Snyder made a mistake then in throwing a bounce pass at that speed. He should have alley-ooped it, and Bricky's such an athlete, he could have downed it.
Nearly 4 minutes gone, second half, after Arizona had led throughout the entire first half by as much as 19, Duke has rallied, and it's the Devils on top by three. Anthony Cook, reach in on Leitner.
Smith got him first. Smith came over and bumped him. Almost called a flagrant foul.
Second on John Smith. Abdel Nabi and Davis return to the Duke lineup. Smith and Leitner go out. Yulbach passes into Cook and a foul on Ferry. Look at Lute Olson say, about time, and he's got to trip tenderly on that sidelines.
Go gently, tiptoe through the tulips. Don't want you back there in the locker room looking at the monitor.
Ferry's first foul. Opik now in for Arizona with the ball. Good move by Opik. Rebound Bricky. 43-40, Duke with the ball and the lead.
Want to get into a set. Half-court offense. Combination down low. See how tight they are down low? Three-point land is open.
Bang. And Quinn Snyder has the answer. A three-pointer for Snyder and a foul.
Awful hard to make up four-point trips down the court. This is their second this half. If he makes the foul
on Bushler, his fourth. That's a big call. Judd Bushler, the best defensive big man for Lute Olson, has just been called for his fourth foul. He comes out.
Which will force Arizona into a zone.
Sean Rooks, a freshman, replaces Bushler. Snyder looking for a five-point trip. Block on Rooks, goaltending Rooks, so Snyder gets 5 points. On a three-point shot and a goaltend, and it's 48-40.
A freshman mistake. That ball wasn't even close to the basket. It was a dying swan. It would have been an air ball.
Duke is hot in the second half as Arizona was in the first. Yulbach with a tough three-pointer falling out of bounds.
Biggest points of the day for Arizona right there.
10 points for Yulbach. Five-point Duke lead. Almost 5 minutes played, second half.
Laying off Davis on the weak side here.
Abdul Nabi, a strong move, and Cook has another block. Here comes Hothick the other way. Numbers on right. He passes to Rooks, and he'll be blocking against Duke. Davis, Brian Davis, gets the call.
Davis slid in underneath here. Watch the move. Again, an angle call. These are impossible calls because it's a judgment call. Here's a sky camera view of it.
And Cook with a block.
Oh, that's a block.
That would be his fifth and his 260th career block. Here's Sean Rooks. Young man suffers from asthma. Often uses an inhaler as he comes out of a game. Looks like Ferry with a basketball body. 6'11 and 243 is Rooks.
Economic call. Good shooter.
And that's his third point of the game. 38-45 Duke. The zone, you predicted, Coach.
They're looking to alley-oop Ricky down low if they can. Ferry comes high. Ricky can slide down. There you go.
Ricky, short. And over the back is Rooks of Arizona. His father played at Parsons of Iowa and was drafted by the New York Knicks, late draft pick in 1969. So he inherits skills from his proud father.
The apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
Final Syracuse winner at home against Kentucky's Wildcats. It appears Eddie Sutton's team will finish on with a losing record. You don't have many of those in Kentucky history. Three-point play for Phil Henderson. Henderson from University Park, Illinois, hits a three. He has seven.
Take you this time, Ricky. There he goes.
Elliott, and Ricky reaches in, gets him on the wrist. And for Robert Ricky, that's his fourth.
That first step by Elliott, that's why he's a super All-American.
You got to square up, you can't reach in. That time Ricky reached in, Elliott's gone.
And Krzyzewski now will reach in and take Ricky out of the game as John Smith replaces him.
They're alternating 10 fouls on Elliott, and man-to-man between Smith and Ricky.
And Elliott needs this point. That gives him 10, and it's the 100th straight time that Sean Elliott has scored in double figures with the Wildcats. But when you erase a name, Lou Alcindor, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, I mean, that takes a big eraser, and that's what Sean Elliott has done with his great career at Arizona.
What I like about both these superstars, Dick, they could have left last year, went for millions, set an example for kids to get their degrees, stay in school for 4 years, do your commitment.
As you said, the hardship is a misnomer. It's hardship only for the NBA, not for the players.
Hardship for the pro owner. Now, the player's doing okay.
51-47, Arizona trails. Elliott with a good move by Smith. And he can't hit again. Ferry rebounds.
Once he starts penetrating, they double team on Elliott.
Ferry trying to pass to Abdul Nabi. Oh, that's a tough bank by Alaa Abdul Nabi. His first points of the game. He played high school ball just some 10 miles away from the Byrne Arena here in the Meadowlands.
And he took the Nile River.
But he was born in Egypt. There's Elliott with that running one-hander.
Born in Alexandria.
53-49. 7 minutes gone. Second half. Duke by four. Ferry in traffic.
Oh, no.
Nope. Basket interference. Abdul Nabi. No basket.
The ball was still inside the cylinder. Half the ball was there. Following up. Touched it. Cost Danny Ferry 2 points. Now watch when he goes up. The ball staying inside that cylinder. See? You can't touch the ball inside the cylinder. The cylinder goes from the circumference of the basket to the ceiling. Now, in international play, you're allowed to do that. Once the ball hits the rim, you can go up there and wipe it out.
Ferry playing a Cook. Cook takes him to the basket and scores a line drive. 53-51, 11 points for Cook.
It's going up. Nope.
Smith. Ferry gets another rebound. And he travels. No basket. So Arizona with a ball and a chance to tie or regain the lead, down by only two.
What's causing all these walks is they're trying to do that head and shoulder fake just to get Cook up in the air, no matter where Cook is.
Well, last night we saw the heavyweight champion Tyson defeat Bruno, and one of the great boxing heavyweight championships of all time, the incredible Cassius Clay, the youngster defeating Sonny Liston 25 years ago. You'll see that following on NBC Sports World. Elliott misses again late in the rebounds. Next on NBC Sports World, Clay versus Liston. Vintage footage. Henderson. Rebound by the little guy, Muehlbach. He breaks out two on two. Elliott with a stop and go. What a play by the All-American. It's tied at 53. 15 now for Sean Elliott.
It's his defense that bothers Duke. 1-1-3. See it? 1-1-3. The guy's in the baseline. The ball gets down to Ferry down low. The double team.
Ferry with 18 points. Can't hit that one. Muehlbach another rebound. Arizona seeking the lead. Great play by Snyder to intercept away from Cook. Snyder at 6'2 is a strong leader. Showed it there. Smith walked. 7 minutes to go.
These are both primetime teams with primetime coaches with Super All-Americans. Here's the pass across court. Elliott gives a head and shoulder fake. Now watch how he keeps his eye in the rim and gives a finger roll.
10:59 left second half. Arizona and Duke dead even at 53. Who's battling for the ACC championship? Jim Valvano got some good news this week.
Yeah, that company's not going to publish the book. Now the problem is that Coach Jimmy B has invited the NCAA into his office to investigate. Now, how do you get the NCAA out of there?
Only kidding.
It's like bringing home flowers for no reason. There's a reason.
Game tied at 53 with 10:45 to go. Sean Elliott over Danny Ferry, partially blocked by Ferry and controlled by Leitner. Snyder goes the other way.
Snyder matured.
Clearing out. And the foul for holding goes against Womack, a freshman for Arizona, Wayne Womack.
WW got caught in his outside. It was a good foul. It was only their fourth team foul.
Six against Duke in the second half. Kubek to Ferry.
Kubek wants to put it up from outside.
Ferry to Snyder.
Back to Kubek right now. Right now.
Quickly around the zone.
Right
the
now.
Key.
Nope. Didn't get around the horn fast enough. Skip it over once. There's a skip. Let it fly. Ooh.
And Kubek, as he set up, dragged his back foot to the sideline in the turnover to Arizona.
And I still think that the NBA three-point line is getting them all confused.
These two coaches, Krzyzewski and Olsen, will be top candidates for our Olympic coach in Barcelona 92. I want you to get us a handicap from your eyes, Al McGuire. Maybe we have time later to give us your top five. Way outside Muehlbach, and that was a pro three-pointer. Out of bounds to Arizona.
21. Well, one thing I believe that the NBA should not be part of. We're good enough to beat them without going to the NBA.
Hold on Kubek as Elliott made his move. No basket. Second on Kubek. And the seventh Duke foul. So Arizona in the one and one the rest of the way. Here comes John Smith.
Blue Devils
on the Duke seniors back in. Olympic coaches, how do you have that handicap? Who would you say is fifth? Well, there it is.
Oh, yeah, he's a dark horse. I think he's going to have a great next couple of years. Fourth, I would go with George Raffin because George was an assistant coach in the last two Olympics.
in L.A. and out in the fold. Danny Crum is the coach of the Pan Am team. Might hurt him.
Okay, who's your pick? Is it Krzyzewski or Olsen?
I don't know. Let me see. I think Olsen. No, I'll take Krzyzewski. I'm not too sure. Olsen. Make an entry.
That's going to be a tough call. Well, that wouldn't be bad if they could get along. Arizona leading 55-53. Snyder, a three-pointer. Leitner with a good rebound and ties it at 55. Christian Leitner, he's a budding star for Duke. 10 points today.
He'll be a star next year.
In the final 10 minutes of the game, even at 55. Ooh, Snyder got away with a real slash. Elliott, and the foul against whom?
Call against Henderson stepping in. Hairline calls always go to the All-Americans.
Fourth foul on Phil Henderson.
Once he starts to penetrate, they're going to double on him. Here goes Elliott. Great body control. There comes Henderson over, steps in. And again, Elliott constantly looking to feed off.
You know, Elliott and this Arizona team, one of the things that Lute Olson does that really is to be admired is he involves all of his players, and they have no choice, in the elementary and secondary school programs, in the reading program, anti-drugs, and reading program. They'll go into elementary schools and high schools and talk about the importance of being able to read and your future education.
Well, what he also does, they got recruiting and everything. He's part of a family, his family, and the team becomes a family. The ball players have veto right in anybody being recruited.
Danny Ferry, no one vetoed him at Duke, that's for sure. The player of the year in high school ball when recruited by Duke, and he gives the Blue Devils a lead, 58-57. Snyder goes the other way now for Duke. Stolen.
Nice steal.
Muehlbach. Muehlbach gives Arizona the lead, 59-58 with his 12th point.
And Arizona takes the lead, 59.
Arizona surprises you with their quickness. They are the rebirth of the West.
It's been some lean years for the West Coast teams. Henderson can't hit. Ferry over the top of Muehlbach. Rebounds. Leitner over the back. He fouls.
That's the seventh. Should be 1-1. And Brooks should go to the shot, I believe. Unless they change on the way down.
Well, we talked with both Krzyzewski and Olsen before the game. They said they'd be honored to be the Olympic coach. And I thought Mike Krzyzewski had a pretty good answer for you in terms of how to pick that coach when you ask him, well, should the Olympic coach be the Pan American Games coach, too?
So I was thinking that the Pan Am coach would be the same one. He said it'd be better if the Pan Am coach became the assistant to the head Olympic coach for the following year.
That way there wouldn't be the pressure of all that time in coaching both Pan Am and Olympic teams, plus your own college team.
There's so much time involved, as you find out from John Thompson and Denny Crum, who did the Pan Am game. I believe our setup going in is creating a problem, but Dave Gavitt will straighten that all out. Dave Gavitt, now the commissioner of the Big East, he is the head of amateur basketball in the United States of America.
Anderson misses the three-pointer. Anderson again, inside, and Cook intercepts for Arizona. And down around his ankles is Christian Leitner with a foul. His second. To the other end, 1-1. Arizona with a 59-58 lead. Here comes Ken Lofton back into the game for Arizona, replacing Othick.
Time of the game, you try to get your starting five back there. Time of the game, you try to go with your stars, guys that have been around. You have some maturity. Your seniors. One, you pick like one, and shooting the pressure.
Well, that's two front ends of 1-1 for Arizona missed. Brooks missed his, and now Cook misses. Cook with an interception. Does he get out of his blocks in a hurry? A jumping jack.
Oh.
Muehlbach around Henderson, sets up Brooks, and
after he dished off Dickie Charge, he couldn't get control. He really should have put it up once he was known that the guy was going to in front of him. He called with a charge.
First on Muehlbach of Arizona, and with it we have a timeout. 7 minutes and 43 seconds remain. We'll be right back after these messages from your local station.
she was able.
Fit the size.
One president to the other. Hey, tomorrow you're going back to your old high school. There must have been 60 students there.
33 in my graduating class.
Armada, Michigan.
Armada, Michigan, yeah.
Armada?
Yeah.
I thought it was Armada.
Trying to get them excited about education. Looking for, I haven't been back home in over 30 years, so we'll talk to some people tomorrow night. Why don't you come along?
Congratulations, Professor.
I'm going to use some of your McGuire-isms. I know at least I'll get a few laughs.
Well, if I go, I need an honorarium.
I can't afford you. Arizona, and these are two teams that could play for the NCAA championship and the championship fight. Ali and Clay to follow on Sports World, and Danny Ferry certainly wears that mantle well, champion. They've retired his number 35 at Duke, and then the women's Kemper Open final round at 4 o'clock after the championship. Sean Rooks, boy, he took it right to the hole.
Yeah, both of these clubs could be in the Battle of Seattle.
61 all with just over 7 minutes to go. Ferry playing on the perimeter now.
Kick the ball down to Leitner, Bricky.
Henderson can't hit the three. Leitner a big rebound. Christian Leitner again inside. And Duke's in front, 63-61. 12 for Leitner. 63-61. Cook. Boy, tough play for Cook. He had to heel his way in.
Adjusted in midair, but Bricky was coming over at him. He's a high flyer.
Ferry. Henderson has it slapped away by Lofton, who saves it to Cook. Ken Lofton with a good play. Gets it ahead to Muehlbach, and the foul is on Snyder of Duke. What kind of move is this, Al? What do you, how would you call this one?
Well, he goes up and he does a little disco right there. There's the disco. There's Ricky coming over. He went around his man. Then he pushed away like he was in a, an alley fight.
Get me out of here. I got my two. I'm going home. Second foul on Snyder, and here's Matt Muehlbach looking for his 13th point of the game. Snyder falling into the lane.
If he missed that foul shot, Dick, they would have given the foul over.
64-63. Arizona back on top at the 6:23 mark. Snyder just awed by that shot. That's right. He had to call him back to the blocks in the 100-meter freestyle. Oh, too tall for Danny Ferry on the pass from Henderson. That's a bad pass, especially for Henderson, because it went right over Krzyzewski's head as well, and he's looking right at you.
Right thought.
Arizona can run. They can get the ball up court. Good transition team. Here's Rooks with a move to the basket and blocked by Bricky, and a foul on Rooks.
Rooks didn't believe that he could block that shot. Bricky's one of the best leapers around for his size.
Sean Rooks, his second personal.
Watch him go uptown.
I asked Bricky, was a high jumper in high school, at his best, he said 6'7", something like that. I said, no, only 6'7"? He said, I only jumped as high as I had to win. I never lost. Never had to jump higher. Three for Snyder. Not there. Boy, they battle for the boards, and Ferry gets a loose ball. And a reach-in on Lofton, and that'll put Duke into the bonus. Ferry to the line, a chance to tie.
Don't you know, Lofton, you don't touch All-Americans.
Winner by Ken Lofton, his first.
Talking about the All-Americans as Bushler comes in for Rooks. Danny Ferry leads all scorers with 21 points and 9 rebounds. Sean Elliott, Arizona's answer, has 19 points and 7 boards.
Does Bushler have 4 personal fouls on him, Dick?
Bushler has 4.
Okay. Next time down, look, Ferry try to take him low and foul him out. He's an important player for the Wildcats.
Ferry misses the second. Arizona leads by a point, 65-64. Both 5.5 to go.
Both teams win 1-1, and the arrow favors Arizona.
Lofton around Snyder, and he is fouled. Robert Bricky gets the foul. fouled, and that's his fifth. So Bricky playing with four, as is Bushler for Arizona. Bricky goes out with 4 points.
You cannot cover man-to-man Super All-American. And they're alternating out there for hot zone. Now, Smith and Bricky have been on Sean Elliott.
1+1.
You'll see that Bueller or Bushler will probably foul out, too.
Lost and misses. That's three times Arizona has lost a chance for points, missing the front end of a 1-1. 65-64. Wildcats lead. Leitner to Ferry to Snyder. Bushler deflects it out of bounds.
No new clock. There's 23 seconds on the shot clock.
And 5 minutes, 6 seconds left in the game. Inside, intercepted. Knocked away by Lofton and controlled by Sean Elliott. His favorite player is Magic Johnson. Cook, Leitner hawking him, and Anthony Cook. You know, he's got that wiry build, but he's strong. He can bump and grind and still make a shot. Has 15 points today.
Doesn't look pretty offensively. Matter of fact, the shot is ugly, but they go down.
67-64, the Wildcats leading the Blue Devils. Ferry. Oh, that's a pro shot. Pro move.
That's showtime. That was a millionaire on a millionaire. Elliott was guarding him.
27 points for Danny Ferry, who set an ACC record and Duke record with 58 against Miami earlier this year. Inside to Cook. The feed by Bushler.
In your interior passing out there, you young guys and girls, try to bounce those interior passes. That's the way to get them through.
Second-ranked Duke leading, or second-ranked Arizona, leading eighth-ranked Duke by three, and Smith gives the Blue Devils a second chance. Snyder to tie it. And it goes over the top. So 2 3-point tries on that trip by Duke. Neither would fall. Anthony is cooking.
Yep. Here's the inside position, and watch him rattle the cage.
The kettle. And 3 minutes, 44 seconds to go. Pontiac, we build excitement. And by the new Michelob Dry. One taste, and you'll drink it dry. 18,196 fans here at the Meadowlands. There'll be a big crowd here again tonight when the Devils and the NHL host Wayne Gretzky and the LA Kings. Top scorers, the All-Americans. Elliott, 19 for Arizona, and Ferry leading all scorers with 27.
Three-point land.
Way off the mark for Muehlbach. And down by three, here comes Duke. 3.5 minutes to play. This is really a preview of the tournament. Two top teams, and they're providing fans with plenty. Ferry, two more.
When they touch the ground like that defensively, that means play defense. Give the maximum effort on defense.
Oh, Snyder, and then Muehlbach saves. Elliott against Ferry. They're matched up eyeball.
Should be able to take him. Clear out of there. Cook, you can take him. Nice good pass.
Oh, what a pass to Bushler, and then he can't make the shot. Henderson rebounds, and now Duke can take the lead. Trailing 69-68.
I want to give a tip of the hat to the three Big East officials. Outstanding job today. Not an easy game to work.
Arizona staying in the zone.
They'll give Duke the outside shot if they want it. Here it is.
Henderson, he's due. Yep. A two-point shot, and Duke leads 70-69. 9 points for Henderson.
Duke stays man-to-man. Look for Arizona to punch it inside.
Elliott up the lane. Sets up Bushler. He fouled by Leitner. Leitner fouls him, but Bushler unable to connect. Third foul on Leitner. Well, this game has certainly had some interesting flows as Arizona started out 9-0, built a 19-point lead at 30-11, cut to 6 points at halftime. Then it was Duke rolling out at the second half. They got the lead, built it to a 6-point advantage, and then it's been seesawing. And we got more great action, as you saw again next weekend here on NBC. Whistler, and the free throw shooting has not been good for Arizona the second half.
Free throw shooting's like the measles or chicken pox. One guy shoots bad, the next guy shoots bad. This is a lunch pail ball play. He's not flashy.
Misses
the job done.
Lane violation, and he'll get another chance.
It happened before. Snyder stepped in earlier. That time, I think Henderson stepped in, looking for rebound position. That could cost him the game.
That ties the game at 70.
That point there could mean the game. Let's see.
2 minutes to go. Each side with 70.
Timeouts. Arizona has three left. Duke has four. Now Duke has three.
Mike Krzyzewski spends one of his timeouts with 1:59 to go here at the Meadowlands. Arizona and Duke are even. With 2 minutes to go. You see how it's pointed, don't you? You see the arrow?
Hey, I didn't even see the Indians.
Milton Berle, circa 1952.
The Texaco hour with the siren.
Well, it's
back to Vaudeville. Here we go. Primetime game.
70 aside. Every pass, every play now could spell victory or defeat. Ferry, did he get away with a push?
Yeah, he pushed off with his left arm on the inside. Danny, you did push that time. Your left arm, elbow on the inside.
Second foul on Ferry.
That's allowed in the NBA, but not in college. Watch. There's the elbow, and there's the push.
So it's Arizona with a chance to get the lead in the final 2 minutes. And it's Elliott with the ball. One-on-one against Ferry.
You want to give Elliott room, you got to move out of that middle, Cook.
This is great. Ferry, the All-America, teamed against Elliott. And Elliott has to let it go.
Uh-oh, they should have got a good call. Now the mistake is there. There should be a foul call. The original call was right. No harm, no foul. But once you created a walk, then the foul had to be called.
That's a good point. And Elliott, of course, barking away just for that reason.
Well, Ferry got a piece of him.
1:12, 1:11, 1 minute 10 seconds to go. And Ferry is short. Cook rebounds for Arizona.
You're looking at two possessions. Arizona, you want to take the shot before 45 seconds. That gives you another possession.
Ferry,
I wouldn't bring it down under 45.
That's good play. Elliott for three. So the two All-Americans, the last two trips, have each taken the ball. Ferry committed a foul and missed the shot. Elliott had a turnover and then hits a three-pointer. And Snyder goes down hard.
Great save by Smith. Get it around to Ferry and three-point land. Let it go, Danny, baby.
It's short. Arizona.
Immediate foul. Timeout for Duke. Right now, set up intentional fouls right away. Stop the clock. 2 seconds won't move off the clock before a foul will be committed.
Krzyzewski asking for the foul. 35 seconds to go. Duke trails 73-70. That was fantastic. Oh, you build up the two great players, one against another, and Elliott from the pro line hits that three-pointer.
Give credit to Lute on that one. See, by him taking a shot at least over 45 seconds, then you got to get the ball back. A lot of times, the end of the game, you get into mathematics, which is difficult on some coaches.
Present company included. Here's the score sheet. Ferry 29 and Elliott 22.
Danny's breaking hard off of this. Sean is coming here, and you've got AC here, you've got Sean here. Sean, the same thing is normal. You face me.
In the huddles, you just wonder what information the kids really do assimilate.
What you do at a timeout, when you first come over, quick timeout again, there's timeout to spare. Arizona called it that time. What happens when the kids first come over, Dick, you usually tell them what's important, one thing. Then you get into the towels and the water and the assistant coaches and so forth. Then before they go back out again, you tell them that one main thing that you called the timeout for. The thing that scared me with my clubs, I always say, do you understand now? And they say yes. And I say, oh, boy, they don't understand. with it. If they said nothing, then they understood.
No, you've got to be ready to move on whatever opening. Yes. You have to be on the other side. After timeout, you ask him because, okay, get back out there.
But they're talking about you can't move.
After a
made basket, you can move. If it's not a made basket, you cannot run that baseline. You're taking the ball, you lose possession.
All right, is he going to... Obviously, he has told them that Duke's going to foul him and be alert for that. Try to move the ball. Don't make the mistake on the turnover. 35 seconds to go in Arizona with the ball and the lead. NBC Sports World. Ali then Cassius Clay against Sonny Liston to follow. And then the final round of the women's Kemper. Lofton all alone is Cook, and that's it for Arizona.
There's time left.
Smith wants the three.
Oh, I told you there was time left. There's plenty of time left.
19 seconds. Boy, did Smith hit a clutch three-pointer.
And they will not go by the 2 seconds this time. Last time they got by because the refs didn't blow it.
You mean that they didn't call the foul that was committed?
Yes. But the foul's being committed intentionally. But as long as you're going for the ball, the refs will not call it a two-shot foul. They call it a one-on-one.
You can run now. He has to. We have how many? Two timeouts. Okay? And Matt, you've got to be our guy that gets open if the rest doesn't go. Okay? You've got to be the guy. Take him deep. Make sure they cut out.
Chris passes. Don't throw the pass in there. Tough with it. Shot. Long and tough.
We're not going to give you a call. He'll give you a call.
We got two left.
Don't forget to tell them, Luke, they can run the baseline now because it's after a basket.
Listen, what I liked about that was the cool manner in which Lute Olson conducted his little huddle. There was no screaming, yelling, emotion. It was be strong, be solid, and the coach trying to symbolize the feelings.
Plus, he doesn't want to get caught with his third technical and be out of this arena.
Here we go, 19 seconds to go. Arizona with a two-point lead.
And we got no seconds off the clock.
Just 1 second used as Brian Davis commits the foul.
Committed by Brian Davis.
His third. Go to the other end, and Sean Elliott, the All-American, will be at the line. Elliott today, as Leitner comes in for Davis. Elliott today has been at the charity 10 times and has made 9. One and one. Pressure on the big shoulders of Sean Elliott. And that forces Duke to get a 3 to tie, and this one would make it very difficult should he make the second.
This one could put the nail in the coffin. They release all their defensive ball players underneath so they won't commit a foul. They're going to be set back, probably going to a zone.
Elliott hits a three-pointer to give Arizona the lead, and then two clutch free throws.
I penetrate all the way. Good move.
Snyder misses. Rebound Lofton of Arizona. And he traveled trying to get out of traffic. 9 seconds to go.
We still got life here, both teams. This game is not over. I would not look for the three-pointer. I'd go for the two-pointer. Here it is.
Snyder gets
right,
the
now
two.
They foul, call a timeout. They foul right away, and there's a chance for OT.
It's amazing what has happened in 19 seconds.
That's why they save their timeouts for great coaches. That's why if technical fouls, you also lost one timeout, there wouldn't be very, very few technical fouls out there. There'd be more respect for the Zebras.
Well, I can't believe this is coming from you. You really, you know, the 12 years away from the game has allowed you to see things differently.
Well, I cleared the trees. I found the light. I'm reborn.
A reborn good guy on the bench. Lute Olson, let's listen in.
Somebody just says, AC, you set the screen for him in the middle. Sean, you're right here. AC is right here. AC set the screen.
AC is Cook now. Watch Cook set the screen. Now you follow Cook. Cook is double zero. He's now in the foul. That's Cook there now. He'll set the screen. He'll probably set the screen for Lofton. No, for Elliott.
Elliott gets knocked down. Cook is fouled by Ferry. 6 seconds to go. So on that 19-second mark, Al, in 13 seconds, we have seen what seems like a half a game.
Well, what happens, you're now in the chess battle. And now it's where the coaches enter. Football's a coach's game. Only the last 2 minutes of basketball is a coach's game. Otherwise, it's a player.
Anthony Cook.
He'll have a job making this.
He is a 62% free throw shooter.
Timeout. As you go to the half court line. Nope, he's going all the way.
Leitner is fouled by Lofton. With 1 second to go, Christian Leitner will go to the line and a chance to tie the game if he can make both.
Lute, I would ice him maybe. That means call a timeout just to dry the sweat on the freshman. Make him think. It's a tough position for a freshman. He has to think positive. Don't take that ball early, son. Take a deep breath. I'd go for the timeout. I'd ice him. Oh, there it is. Oh, Lute, you're listening. Oh, baby. That freshman, now that pink elephant starts going. I used to do in this position, I put that freshman in front of the bench, I get two basketballs, two guys throwing the ball at him, alternating to keep him in heat, keep him sweating. Heat's the wrong word there.
What would you tell you? Would you tell him anything?
I would know. Wouldn't talk to him at all. I ignore him. I put him down the end of the bench with two balls being thrown at him, alternating. Then out he goes. Nobody talks to him.
You did that? I never saw you do that.
I did that every time I was in this situation. I didn't even know you then, Dick.
And didn't want to either. You saw Leitner's statistics. He's a 70% shooter from the line, so he's better than average.
Ah, what a game. College basketball at its best.
Yes. Game leading up to and living up to all that we hoped it would be. Here are two teams that could go all the way to Seattle.
Either coach could be our Olympic coach in Barcelona, Spain in 92, which NBC has.
Christian Leitner.
Leave him alone. Don't talk to him. Danny's got his eyes down. Don't look at him. Don't take that ball until it's given to you. Don't go on the foul line. It's a good play, kid. Stay back there. I'm going to wait as the ball comes, son. Watch him take a deep breath. Let's see if he takes that deep breath. He took a shadow shot that time. Six bounces. All right, put up a prayer.
Rebound, Sean Elliott. Arizona beats Duke 77-75.
Congratulations to Arizona, the Wildcats. You deserve number one. Georgetown, number two.
And you saw what Mike Krzyzewski did. It's only one loss now. He went right to Leitner, said that's okay. He's already coaching for the next game.
He's already coaching for the next 3 years. That kid's only a freshman.
Krzyzewski on the sidelines watching his freshman with a chance to tie.
Thank you for coming.
Chance. Arizona from the West leaves with a big win. Number two Wildcats. Are they now number one? We'll be right back after this.
And it came down to the wire, Rich, and we'll pass it along to you now. Second-ranked Arizona taking on Duke today. With a win, the Wildcats will become number one in the country. We pick up action in the ballgame. Cook with a slam for Arizona. And watch this little guy. He can't believe what a great basketball game he's watching, so he wants to get a better look at it. And we pick up the buckets down low with Danny Ferry, as always, producing a great move there in the paint, off the glass, up and in. Game tied. Under a minute to go, All-American Sean Elliott drills the three-pointer. So Arizona was up by three, but Duke used the clock very well, had a last chance here. And you'll see their defense let down. Christian Leitner gets the pass from Ferry. He's fouled with just 1 second left. Now a great move by Lute Olson, Arizona coach, calls a timeout to ice the freshman. He goes over, has to think about it for a little while, and then comes out. If he makes the two free throws, the game is tied. Front end of a 1-1 doesn't go down. And Arizona will be number one as they beat Duke 77-75. And you see Coach Mike Krzyzewski there talking to Leitner. telling him not to worry about it, shake it off. That NCAA tournament is coming up. How about Syracuse today at the Carrier Dome?
Blue Devils looking to move up in the top 10. Larry, you had two top 10 college basketball teams meeting head-on today at the Meadowlands in Jersey. One of those made-for-TV matchups that's great for the fans because they get to see two of the best teams in the country, and it's great for the players because it's a non-conference game with neither team worrying about making the NCAA tournament. I mean, they know they're going win or lose, so they can let it all hang out, put on a good show, and the result is usually a good game. And that's exactly what ninth-ranked Duke and second-ranked Arizona gave us today, although early on, it looked like it would be a big day for the Wildcats of Arizona. Duke was cold early. Anthony Cook altering the shot of Ala Abdelnaby. Before Duke knew it, Kenny Lofton's jumper makes it 9-0 Arizona. Anthony Cook continued to cause trouble defensively. Here he'll block Abdelnaby, 4.5 blocks for Cook. And this three-pointer by Arizona's Muhlenbach gives the Wildcats a 30-11 lead, but Duke comes back. Danny Ferry to Christian Leitner. Time running out. Coach K calls the signals. What else? A Danny Ferry three-pointer. Duke is down only 6.5. Second half, the momentum continues for the Blue Devils. Inside it goes to Leitner for the layup. Duke on a 16-2 run to start the second half. It was close the rest of the way, though. Sean Elliott, baseline drive, ties the game at 53. Besides the blocks, Anthony Cook contributed offensively. Cook slicing and dicing, moving inside, finishing with 19. This hoop tied the game at 63. Now with Arizona leading by one. Quinn Snyder to Phil Henderson. Duke leads by one. Late in the game, we're tied at 70. Elliott over Ferry. Wildcats up by three. With Arizona up by 2 and 6 seconds to go. Cook at the foul line misses the shot. Ferry brings it up for Duke. Ahead to Leitner. Remember, they're only down by two. Leitner on the way to the hoop, and he is fouled with 1 second left. Now, Leitner's a freshman, so what is Lute Olson going to do? He's going to call a timeout to ice him. This is a one-on-one situation. It was the right move because Leitner throws up a prayer, and it is not answered. Off the back iron, Arizona with a rebound and a two-point victory at the Meadowlands. And look at that, a class move by Mike Krzyzewski. He told the freshman, look, son, it's okay. It's not life and death. You got three more years. A class move by Coach K and a class win for Arizona by two.
Are going to happen, especially on national TV. The Arizona Wildcats stake their claim to the number one spot in college basketball by holding off Duke this afternoon. Now, top-ranked Oklahoma was knocked off yesterday, so number two Arizona looks pretty solid to regain the top ranking it held just 3 weeks ago. The Duke's Mr. Everything, Danny Ferry, led all scorers in this game with 29 points against Arizona. The Blue Devils had rallied from a 16-point first-half deficit to open an 8-point lead in the second half. Quinn Snyder from three-point land. But the game was tied at 70 with 54 seconds left when Sean Elliott for Arizona nails the three-pointer. That gave the Wildcats the lead. Now, Christian Leitner had 12 points, had a chance to tie it with 1 second left, but he missed on the front end of a 1-1 at the line, and Arizona came away with a 77-75 win to raise its record to 21-3. So the Wildcats will be number one again next week. Meanwhile, the sixth-ranked Syracuse Orangemen had not played in 8 days and were a little slow.
Yeah, I mean, Christian Leitner had a shot today to tie things up and send it to OT. Tough spot to be in, Rich. And the nice thing was the class shown by Duke coach Mike Krzyzewski afterward. He said, hey, don't worry about it. Let's pick it up. Arizona number two claiming the top spot. And you see the Blue Devil fans on hand at the Meadowlands today as Arizona went against Duke. Down low, Cook gets the slam, got a great feed in the paint. Game tied. Under a minute to go, the All-American, Sean Elliott, and he rattles that one home, so it was a three-point lead. Then it became a five-point lead as Cook gets another layup on the breakaway, but Duke battled back. They used the clock nicely. It was a two-point deficit with 1 second left. Christian Leitner was fouled, had a chance to tie it, send it to OT, but as you see, his shot was strong. Didn't come up short on it, put a little too much mustard on it, and Arizona wins it by two, 77-75. Arizona, now number one in the country.